It's me, sir. O'Brien too, sir. I'm dead. Dabo.
My O'Brien impression is really bad. Anyway, yeah, so there you go. If that's your first Deep Space Nine episode, they're not always that episodic. Sometimes they're quite heavily serialized and there's a lot of continuity. But that is a fun, darkly depressing episode, but I think a really good one. Even if there's some plot lines that you kind of need previous episodes to know what's going on, you can still watch it on its own. And it's an example of one of the many O'Brien must suffer episodes. So now you know the Worf barrel episode. Now you know the O'Brien clones. We're the same, sir. You and I. There's other episodes that are quite depressing for O'Brien. Whispers, Tribunal, Visionary. That's the one we just watched. Hard Time in particular. The Assignment, Honor Among Thieves, and Prodigal Daughter. And there's actually a video compilation of O'Brien being destroyed multiple times. But, you know, you're going to have to watch some of that on your own. It's good. It's a good show. And O'Brien gets shit on because he's like kind of the everyman. You know, he's got a wife and a kid. He's, you know, just kind of like the hard-working, blue-collar dude on the station who knows his shit, and you know, he's not like an alien. He doesn't have some like fucked up storyline of like great superpowers. He's just like a really competent chief, a really competent mechanic who, when he was aboard the Enterprise, would literally stand at a transporter console for hours at a time, wait for someone to enter, and then say, "Where are you going?" Even though they could just teleport from wherever. Just totally wasting all of his abilities. There's a comic series called O'Brien at Work that you may enjoy if you haven't already seen it. Like, for example, here's one. It's just him at the console. And then, like, the last, second to last panel. I could transport all of you into space right now if I wanted. Or like this one. Where it's just, he's, let's be friends, right? Excuse me, I'm looking, oh, sorry, wrong room. No, wait! I can transport you to any room you want. So there's quite a few of these. Many, probably, I think a couple hundred of them by now. Just like a long series that just keeps going. But yeah, so now you know, chat. Now you are informed at least one episode. I figured we could, you know, it's New Year's. And I'm used to watching The Twilight Zone. That was a very Twilight Zone-y kind of episode. It's a time-fucky episode. Temporal mechanics make zero sense. But that's okay. But yeah, last thing I'll say about it is I would recommend watching Deep Space Nine, but it is a fucking time sink in a good way. I'm rewatching it. I'm on season 6, and I skipped some of the first season and some of the second season, and then I watched all from there. And it's been really great. It really is one of my favorite shows of all time. Sphinx was doing viewing parties of it, and it got me hooked back on it. But I understand this might be annoying, the watch party thing. It's just convenient, and it's just a lot of people that can watch it. And I figured it would be kind of fun to see what a watch party would look like, you know, for Deep Space Nine with like 2,000 people. And it was insanity, but also kind of fun. So I apologize to those that don't have the Amazon Prime. You know, that's why I gave the timestamp, just in case. But I hope you enjoyed it. It was an episode I saw a couple months ago again. And I still liked it enough the second time, and I figured, fuck it, why not a third time today? But I'd still recommend watching Star Trek The Next Generation first, and then Deep Space Nine. Those two work really well, one into the next. So, everybody that's still here, I'll be back. The original series. You can watch original series later, I think. I think it's good to watch original series at some point and see if you like it. As I've said before, Enterprise is good. They're all good. The original, maybe is my third favorite behind TNG and DS9. Voyager even has some great episodes, and Enterprise has some great episodes. Just didn't ever really get a chance to shine as much as it could have. But, you know, TNG is my starting recommendation, and then DS9 you can go to from there. But if you want to do original series first, it's only three seasons, and some of the continuity from the original series works okay with TNG. It's not required, though. So yeah, that's the Star Trek stuff. I've been getting back into it a lot lately, and it's been really good for me. I've enjoyed it. It's like a warm comfort show, even when O'Brien is made to like suffer and die multiple times in one episode. But now you know, now you understand the plight of O'Brien, and VR chat will make a whole lot more sense. But okay, for real though, I gotta go. I'm gonna eat something soon. I will be back. I'm going to be doing some probably AI Dungeon. I might do Animal Crossing for the countdown timer, because that will be easy. And, you know, we can hang out with Scoot. That seems like a good thing to do. In you know, this year has been heavily dominated by Animal Crossing streams. So why not? That seems like a good New Year's Eve thing. And again, it has a countdown, so that makes my life easy. And I may have my top games of the year list and maybe a bonus materials that I will also stream tomorrow. So that's what I'm thinking. I'm not going to tell you what the bonus materials is yet, but I think many of you will enjoy it. So stick around. Well, not now at least, but if you want to, you can come back in about an hour, maybe a little over an hour. And I'll do some New Year stuff. If you don't come back and you have your own stuff to do, well, listen, thank you for being here with me this year. And I hope you have a safe and good New Year's Eve. And I hope you take care of yourselves. And, you know, I hope everyone's good. So best wishes for the new year for all of us. And I hope I have my own goals. And I hope yours, you know, again, the number just changing doesn't make things automatically better. It takes work, and I'm going to be putting that work in, and I hope it's a good year. I really do. I hope 2021 is great. I'm optimistic at the very least. So, all right, peace out, everybody. Catch you later. Thanks for watching Star Trek with me. I know it's great, nerdy as fuck, but great. I'll catch you later.